Please see this paper. There's a three circle. And I would like to dictate one more table. You can draw it in the back side. Can anyone give a pencil? Now let me just do it and dictate. This you need to do by your own hand so that you will remember it. That's why I never print this and give. Please make a table like that. You can just four columns should come. Okay. Once you finish the drawing, then I'll explain step by step. There is two state of your being and two state of your mind. Two state of your being means with the I consciousness, the state in which you are now. There is one more state of being without I consciousness. In the deep sleep and in the dream you don't have clear I consciousness. You don't have clear I consciousness. Now you have. The deep sleep, do you have the feeling of I? No. These are two levels of being. So put please with I, without I. I and no I. That's two levels of beings. And two states of mind. With thoughts, without thoughts. Now with thoughts. The deep sleep, do you have thoughts? No. Without thoughts. These are the two state of the mind and two state of the consciousness, being. Two state of being and two state of mind. You can write even little more explanation if you want. With thought and without thought. State of mind. This thought, with thought and without thought is state of minds. With I and without I is state of consciousness. These two states cross each other. Now let me explain about that. All of you have written the table. Let me now explain, then you can write. Please listen. then you can write. With thought and with eye consciousness, your eye feeling also will be there, thoughts also will be there, means waking state, the present state in which you are now. There will be no eye, the eye feeling will not be there, but the thoughts will be there. That is what is the dream state. In dream state, you will see continuously thoughts are flowing, but you don't have a stable eye. In the waking state, you have the same eye, continues to work. Yesterday eye and today eye, almost every eye has got the same identity. In the dream state, yesterday dream is different eye, today dream is different eye. You don't have eye, you don't have solid eye, but you have thoughts. Thoughts, but no eye. That is what is dream state. And the third, no eye, no thoughts. The feeling of eye also is not there. Thoughts are also not there. That is what is deep sleep. And there is a fourth state. Thoughts will not be there, but pure consciousness will be there. That is what is the samadhi state. Now we don't have to bother about this fourth state. If these three states are clear, automatically you fall into this fourth state. Now we are going to work on these three states. All of you are clear about this table, please you can write down. Any of you are teacher or professor? Yes. Then come forward and explain so that I will understand you all understood. I'll be sure that you all have understood what I expressed. This is the beauty of the small crowd. We can clearly see step by step that whole group follows what we express and then proceed. But when it is a mass, oh God, you can't even make them silent. In India, you do not know. In India, they will bring the kids also. I will be giving a discourse on a deep Vedantic truths, and these kids will be sitting and playing in front of with a doll and toy train. Yes, please come forward and explain. You only? Yes. You are the teacher. So that I will understand, the whole group understood. Four states of being is expressed.
You said, I, the conscious thing, me, and no I, non-conscious state.
No, to them.
Then you said, with thought and without thought. You said, when there's the eye consciousness with thoughts, we are the waking state. The eye no eye, but still with thoughts going to us, is the dream state. You also said that when we have no thoughts and no consciousness of eye, we are in deep sleep. And you said, but when we have the eye consciousness without thoughts, we go into a samadhi state.
Meditation. That's nice. Beautiful. Now, let you understand, as you think you don't have one body, you have three layers of body. Your body is actually three layers. It is not one layer. It is not one body as we all usually assume. In this three state, you assume three bodies. In all these three states, you assume three bodies. The first state, waking, is what is called physical body. The body which you are having now, the present body, the physical body made of flesh and bones. When it comes to the dream state, you assume your body called subtle body. You are sleeping in St. Louis, but suddenly you dream that you are in India, with your parents, with your friends, with your relatives. With which body did you travel to India? Without body you can't. The body which you assume in the deep dream state, that is what we call subtle body. Third thing, the body which you assume in the deep sleep state, a total darkness, that is what we call causal body. Here in this, all the three are given, physical, subtle, causal. Physical is the outer layer, subtle is the second layer, third is causal body. The physical body is made of flesh and bones, the stuff which you are seeing. The subtle body is made of stuff, your suppressed desires and suppressed fears. For example, if you take up fasting for 3 days, don't eat and fast, exactly in that night you will see in the dream you are having a good feast. How many any of you have experienced? Anything you suppress, you will enjoy in the dream, in the subtle body. Your suppressed desires and suppressed fear also. If you suppress any fear continuously, you will have the same dreams. If you are afraid of snake, continuously you will see snakes in the dream. If you are afraid of elephant, continuously you will see elephants in the dream. So your suppressed desire and suppressed dreams, suppressed fears, they form subtle body. Third thing, your deepest layer of your energy, your being, forms the causal body, the third level body. Now, all our problems, when I say all, I mean capital letter A-L-L. All our problems originates, all our problem starts when these three bodies are not eased with each other. If they are not eased with each other, only then dis-ease starts. If they are diseased with each other, something happens to your body, what we call disease. If they are diseased, you are into disease. How to find out whether my three bodies are eased with each other or not? A small experiment. You all must be experiencing early morning when you get up and start taking bath. You will see you are thinking about your office. When you are in the office working, you will be thinking about beach or St. Louis Arch. I will go to the Mississippi River and relax. And when you are in the bank of the river, you will be thinking about going back to the house. The moment you reach the house and start eating, you will start thinking about the next day office work. If you are in the house, your mind is in the office. If you are in the office, your mind is in the beach. If you are in the beach, again your mind is in the house. One thing is sure, where you are not there. Where your body is, you are not there. If you feel ease, comfortable inside this system, you will never run around. You will be in the present moment. You will be residing in this body. As on now, we never reside in this body. This body is only center for our being. But always we are on out. We are on our picnic. We are on our vacation. always here, somewhere else. That is the first proof that we are not ease with this body. Your subtle body means the mind is not ease with the physical body. Many times you can see, you will be able to sit with TV, you will be able to sit with somebody, you will be able to sit with your laptop, but you will not be able to sit with yourself. Sitting with yourself is a big thing for us. We can't sit with ourselves. We want something to be done. Something continuously should go on. Even if you have nothing, you start thinking. Even if there is nothing, you start thinking. After all, you have one big heart worrying. Something you start worrying about. So, if nothing is there also, you continue to think. You never sit with yourself. Only when you know the art of sitting with yourself, you will understand how much you missed in the life by not learning sitting with yourself. Learning to sit with yourself is the greatest art that opens a new dimension for your being. Very new dimension for your being. See, as long as you learn, as long as you do not know to sit with yourself, as long as you learn only to sit with something else, you are learning the arts of outer world. Only when you can sit with yourself, you are learning the arts of inner world. Did you understand one more thing? If you don't know how to sit with yourself, how to relax with yourself, you can never taste what I call health. You should understand the definition of health from Ayurveda. According to Ayurveda, health does not mean clinically fit. According to allopathy, health means clinically all right. If you don't have disease, if you don't need to be treated, if you don't need to take any medicines, if you don't need any health care things, then you are called healthy. But according to Ayurveda, that is not health. Ayurveda says, a positive well-being, positive overflowing energy is what is called health. No diseasedness is only negative part of health. It is not totality of health. A positive overflowing well-being, a life, energy, a continuous Shakti Spurana is what we call health. In Ayurveda, the definition for health itself is totally different. Overflowing energy is what they call health. And there is one beautiful example. The early morning, when you get up from your bed, your steps to the bathroom should not be steps, it should be more like a dance. Then you are healthy. According to Ayurveda, early morning is the time. These two bodies meet the third body. All the three come in touch the moment you wake up from the bed. That's the time all these three are alive. That is the time to measure whether you are healthy or not. Whether you are healthy or not. Because that is the time you are conscious, subconscious, unconscious. All the three will be available to your being. In the total wakeful state, by morning and noon, only the conscious state will be available to you. In a dream state, only subconscious will be available to you. In a deep sleep, only unconscious will be available to you. The early morning is the time all the three will be available to you. So that is the time to find out whether you are healthy or whether you are diseased with other bodies. In that moment, if you are alive, ecstatic, be sure you are healthy. That only is going to decide whether we are healthy or not. Whether you are healthy or not too. Measure whether we are healthy or not, that is the scale.